passively, whether it be through, you know, ads on my blog, joint venture products where, you know, I just plug some guy's product or service for a post, let it sit out there and earn, you know, income that way, or, you know, a variety of other means. But, you know, I basically don't want to have to work for a living. That's, you know, that's my goal. After reading the 4-Hour Workweek, I decided to pursue this little project I have. It's going to be a guitar blog, an all-guitar blog. No, you know, weird, wacky posts that aren't guitar. Yeah, I decided to get on, you know, hop on the whole niche train. It's like, okay, just talk about nothing but guitars. It's going to be called, tentatively, it's going to be called theshred.com. Obviously, it's going to be, you know, more shred guitar oriented. That's not to say that it's going to be all shred guitar. It's just mostly going to be shred guitar. So you're going to see artists, you know, you're going to see artists like, you know, Marty Friedman, Paul Gilbert, Zakk Wylde, Steve Vai, Joe Satriani, those kind of guys. But that's not to say, you know, I'll show nothing but those kinds of guys. You know, I might highlight, you know, classic players, whether it's the, you know, been beaten to death players like Jimmy Page, Eddie Van Halen, or it's, you know, up-and-coming people that, you know, I might not even know about at the time. I want to outsource pretty much all the work involved in theshred.com, whether including its design, the majority of its posts. Basically, the only thing I want to do, you know, where I have to actually do some work would be, you know, maybe some decisions and content posting, maybe some design. You know, I obviously, you know, help design it, but I don't actually do the work. I outsource all my work to people in other countries, kind of what Tim Ferriss was talking about in his book, 4-Hour Workweek. So I wanted to see how that went. Now, obviously, it's going to take some money because I'm not doing everything in order to make this work. But I feel that with, you know, professionals who actually, you know what they're doing, I'll have a better chance at being able to monetize it. Basically, the idea of theshred.com is going to be based off of a site called blabbermouth.net. It's not going to be, you know, open sourced like Wikipedia. It's going to have, you know, the people that I outsource pulling in press reports and things like that from labels and actually going out and doing some research. Now, what I will do, being the final say on everything that goes on with that site, I plan on doing interviews with the various artists. Posting them up as videos would be, you know, something else that I can monetize, whether it be through things like Rever.com, or I want to get The Shred as a publicized magazine, which I think would be, you know, pretty kick-ass. But I talked to John about it, and he says, well, you know, it's, you know, you won't make a lot of money off of it. But my whole thing is, you know, it's not that I want to make a lot of money. You know, I don't want to necessarily be rich for riches, for being rich's sake. I want to be able to have money I can actually do stuff with instead of just, you know, having money. Because, I mean, you get a lot of rich people out there who, you know, work and work and work and work to death, literally sometimes. And, you know, they have all these millions of dollars and all these really nice cars and the nice house and all that stuff, but they're too busy working to enjoy it. That's the reason I want to set up, you know, these passive streams of income, so that way I have the time to enjoy what I'm pulling in. Whether or not I become a millionaire or not, you know, is irrelevant. I want to at least have enough money to be able to reasonably support myself, you know, have enough to at least, you know, pay rent on an apartment, pay off all my expenses, and have a little bit of spending money on the side. That would be, well, not really ideal, but that would be, that's what I at least want. I at least want enough money to be able to pay off. Anything more, you know, is just great, you know. If I get enough money to buy a new or a nicer car, but I don't necessarily need, you know, thousands and thousands of dollars, or even millions of dollars, as long as I have the freedom to do what I want with those, with, you know, the money that I have. That's not necessarily, I'm not trying to say that, you know, I want to be poor all my life and live in an apartment. You know, I obviously want to move up in the world, but okay, let me just kind of rephrase this whole thing. Okay, basically, my goal is to generate income passively through my websites, so that way I don't have to work, I don't have to spend, you know, gobs and gobs of time, whether it be doing work that I don't like Walmart or whatever, or working too much on the sites. If I want to sleep all day, if I want to putz around and watch TV, I can watch TV. I don't have to, you know, look at the clock and like, oh shit, I gotta go to work at 6, you know, I gotta wrap this up. That's basically my goal. Now, I see that this video has gone on for a ridiculously long time, and the battery hasn't gone dead yet, so that's kind of a plus. In conclusion, I'm going to be working on a guitar blog called theshred.com. It's going to be focused mostly on shred guitar-oriented artists, as well as, you know, maybe classic artists. I'm going to try to outsource as much as I can from it, except for doing interviews, post those interviews as vlogs, whether it be on YouTube, Rever, GoogleVideo.com, whatever, or just post them directly, I don't know, and begin to monetize the site and make a living off of it, as well as getting help from my personal blog, mainly, you know, better setting it up, finding better ad networks or things that would, you know, better drive, get me money through my personal blog as well as through theshred.com. I also have ideas for a bunch of other blogs too, like even the current other blog that I have, which I haven't paid too much attention to pretty much since I put it up, was spicymelon.com. Spicymelon.com was supposed to be, you know, according to the description, an online cookbook for the eccentric and poor. And what I wanted to do was put up recipes that were cheap, easy, and or off the wall. You know, it's good for college students, bachelors who don't know how to cook anything, moms who want to, you know, cook stuff with their kids but are afraid of them getting burned, or a recipe that's too complicated or needs weird fancy ingredients or whatever. I also wanted to do a blog called itsthemoon.com, where it'd basically be a picture blog, and I would post one picture of the moon every day. I was waiting until I got a camera to get this, and now that I do, I have the ability to do that, but the problem is, this camera doesn't do very well, you know, as far as night shots go. I'll probably have to, you know, wait longer until, you know, I get a camera that can better handle night shots and can photograph the moon every night. Because, I mean, there's a lot of locales around here that I want to photograph the moon off of, especially since, you know, we got the lake. Pretty much moon plus lake equals awesome. So, I mean, I could photograph from pretty much anywhere, as long as, like, the lake or something like that is in the picture, then, I mean, I'm golden.